great, Logan, tonight. Very first time ever seen it. And same shoes, and same line. This seems like not too long ago. What blessing it is and an honor to be allow my son to reach behind this sacred pulpit. What blessing. The thought of where I used to be. I shouldn't be standing here right now. If I got what I deserved, I'd land it in prison somewhere. Been in jail. It's what I deserve. I'm glad God turned my life around.
Amen.
I believe because of that, I've got a boy now. I'm saved. Now it's just called preach. Got another back here. Coming up. Got saved. You're all back. Baby girl has been praying for me. Just every now and then, get down there and whisper in her ear, Jesus. Jesus. Jesus.
Hey.
Well, Logan, you come on tonight, buddy. You'll probably shed a few tears, and that's all right. Let's pray.
Okay, I'm going to bring a message entitled, The Second Coming.
Hey.
If you would, if you got your Bibles, turn to 1 Thessalonians 4. We'll start at verse 13. We're going to just stand for God. But I don't have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that ye sorrow not even as others which have no hope. But if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so then also which sleep in Jesus will bring them fruit with him. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall ever be with the Lord. Wherefore, comfort one another with these words. May God encourage you.
Gracious time, Heavenly Father. Lord, Father, I thank you for the tears. I thank you for the spirit that's flowing out of me, Father. I pray, God, you're with my brother, Father, my little brother, Father. And you'll touch him tonight, Father, with your Holy Spirit, Father. And preach him hard, Father. I pray, God, you use him, Father, tonight, Lord. Use him as a vessel, Father. We know he's nothing without you, Father. I pray, Lord, as he decreases, Father, that you'll send the increase, Lord. In Jesus' name, I do pray. Amen.
They will go up first with him. And then 1 Thessalonians 4:17 means that Christians that are alive will go second after them. Then the last verse, we need to comfort each other with those verses. He's gonna be coming soon. I can feel it. And there's gonna be a 7-year of tribulation. I'm glad I won't be on the earth when that time comes. I'll be up in heaven praising the Lord, thanking Him for everything He's done for me. Now, I'm going to turn to Revelation 13. That first verse, it says, "And I stood upon the sea, saying of the sea, and saw a beast rise up out of the sea, having 7 heads and 10 horns, and upon his horns 10 crowns, upon his head the name of blasphemy." There's going to be one beast from the sea when that time comes. And then, "And the beast which I saw, like a leopard, and his feet were as the feet of a bear, and his mouth as the mouth of a lion, and the dragon gave him his power, and his seat and great authority. And I saw one of his heads as it were wounded to death, and his wound was healed, and all the world wondered after the beast. And they worshipped the dragon which gave power to the beast, and they worshipped the beast, saying, Who is like unto the beast? Who is able to make war with him? And there was given unto him a mouth, speaking great things and blasphemy, and power were given unto him, continued 42 months. And he opened his mouth and blasphemies against God to blaspheme his name and his tabernacle, and men that was dwelled in heaven." Okay, there should never be an S on the end of Revelation.
Amen.
There is only one Revelation, which is the beginning. "And it was given unto him to make war with the saints and to overcome them, and power given him, hundreds and tongues and nations. And all that dwell upon the earth shall worship him whose names are not written in the book of the life of the Lamb, slain from the fountain of the word. If any man have an ear, let him hear. He that liveth into captivity shall go into captivity. He that killeth with the sword must be killed with the sword. He is patient in faith of the saints." Okay, that was just the first beast. There's going to be 2 beasts during that tribulation period. And it's going to be the beast out from the earth. "And I beheld another beast coming out of the earth, And he had two horns like a lamb, and he spake as a dragon. And he exercises all the power of the beast brought before him, and causes the earth and then the first beast whose deadly wound was healed. And he doeth great wonders so that he maketh fire come down from heaven on the earth in the sight of men, and deceiveth them that dwell on the earth by the means of those miracles which he had power to do. The sight of the beast saying, and he had power to give his life into the image of the beast, that the image should both speak, would not worship the image of the beast, should be killed. Okay, the last three verses of that chapter. Okay, so if you're not saved, you're going to have to take the mark of the beast while you're still down on the earth. But if you are saved, you'll be with Jesus in heaven. So you have to take the number of the beast, which is 666, either on your forehead or your right hand to be able to eat. If you don't, then you cannot eat in that period. If you try to kill yourself, you ain't gonna die.
Amen.
You'll be staying there in total torment. But if you're saved, like I said, you'll be in heaven with God.
Amen.
And then when we come back, when he comes back on a white horse,
there he is.
We'll be on a white horse coming back. And then, well, I told you guys that about he's coming soon. Well, if you would go look at chapter 22, verse 7, it says, "Behold, I come quickly. Blessed is he that keepeth the sayings of the prophecy of this book." And then when you go to verse 12, it says, "And behold, I come quickly.
Yeah.
And my reward is with me to give every man according as his work shall be." Okay. So there's going to be a tribulation period. And if you're not saved in that time, then you'll stay on here being all this torment and horrible and everything. And there's going to be beasts and everything. And then if you're saved, you'll be with me in heaven and God. Verse 20, it says, "He which testified these things said, surely I come quickly. Amen, even so come, Lord Jesus." And I'll just read the last verse because it's one of my favorite verses. "The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. Amen."
Amen.
That means that read this book and you want to, and you're going to take it in heart, then His grace is going to be with you.